Hey Commanders, this is Sapphire Sky, and in today's unit breakdown, we'll be going over Paladin. So, let's get right into it. Paladin belongs to the Order faction and is available early on in the game at rank 5, and is a straightforward unit to understand and can be extremely useful as you are navigating your way to the top of the ranks. As I hope you've noticed, Paladin is surrounded by a golden circle. This golden circle is their aura, and it heals every friendly unit that is entirely inside of their aura that does not belong to the Construct or Chaos factions. So, it's a constant healing ray of sunshine that also cleanses and removes play conditions a unit may have. Paladin is a very versatile unit and can pair well with pretty much any unit in the game. However, it does depend on the type of army that you want to build. Consider Righteous Defenders, Battle Drummer, Eternal Champions, Monster Hunter, Arcane Blades, and even Warhounds and Wolves are great units to pair them with. Above all others, there's one, though, that beats them all. This one is Battle Drummer. Battle Drummer and Paladin are BFFs and should go into the fight together. It's a little bit too long to explain and to go over why, but in the meantime, don't forget to hit and like that subscribe button. Most Chaos units do not work well with Paladin. Obviously, do not pair Paladin with Untamed Beast, as your Beast literally will slaughter your Paladin if they are close enough. Lastly, do not, and I repeat, do not pair them with a Death Knight. We learned from our previous video on Valkyrie that Death Knight cancels any and all healing. These two are not meant to be paired up together. Place Paladin in the middle of the battlefield and to the front, closer to the enemy field, basically towards the middle and to the right. Since Paladin is a big, chunky unit, they are slightly slower than most, and placing them in the middle guarantees the maximum amount of coverage. Placing your Paladin within this general area allows your allies to reach Paladin just as they are starting to gear up for battle. Paladins are great against Plague Throwers, Plague Bearers, and Draining Spirits. Since Paladin's aura cleanses and heals, it cancels any plague condition and starts to heal you right after. So these three units in particular are cancelled. If you start seeing Thorn Guards, Mind Corruptor, Mind Shrooms, a Death Knight, Cannoneer, Faceless Knights, or Crows, and any units that give freeze or burn, you might want to consider either an army change-up, since these units on your enemy sides will do significant damage to your Paladin. Or, if you're brave enough, equipping the right kind of power stones such as Resist will help you get the job done. Other good power stones to form a strategy around are Berserk, Protection, Thunder Shield, and Clone. Again, these are only available during certain eras, so keep that in mind. From all of these power stones though, the most important one is Resist. Artifact pairing depends on what type of army you're using. So if you're using a swarm army, use a Worn Horn. If not, a Giant Toe. Pendant or Crown would be lovely to pair with Paladin, but if you're not using a swarm army and have Giant's Toe available, definitely use that instead. Here's one last thing to consider. Paladin's healing is based on a base attack. Therefore, other forms of damage increase, like power stones and artifacts, will not increase the aura's healing power. All right, Commanders, I'll catch you all next time. Thanks so much for watching. Happy spinning.